Hello everyone, this is Mumbo here, welcome back, and today we're back on the Hermitcraft server. It is episode 35 and we're currently over here down at the bottom of the Mumbo Jumbo, ready to start recording another video. And I've got to tell you, ladies and gentlemen, I have been waiting to do this episode for a very long time now, because today we are going to be working on all of the redstone for the sorting system that is going to put all of our common blocks into storage silos. So that's things like cobblestone, dirt, and all that sort of stuff. They are all going to be going in storage silos down at the bottom of this area. But anyway, if you missed the previous episode of Hermitcraft, I'm telling you, you missed out on a treat. That was such a good episode. We managed to get a ton of stuff done. As you can see, I have fixed the roof area. The roof area is looking really good now. We've got some snow in these sections, and we also have some birch wood. But more importantly, check it out. Oh boy, doesn't the outside area look absolutely fantastic? When I originally built it, I was a little bit unsure about this part in the middle. I believe that block is called diorite. So we had the diorite in the middle. I was a little bit unsure about it, but I read through your comments, and also I've been looking at it for a while now, and I'm pretty happy with it. I think it looks really cool. It breaks up the iron, and it's definitely a good addition to the build. So I am happy with this outside area. But anyway, today we're going to be working on this central section, and I'm sure it is going to work really quite well. So I think the first thing that I'm going to do today is I'm actually going to do a little bit more digging. You see, we did this in the previous episode, but I would say that this isn't quite deep enough. We need more space to put more chests and more storage in so that it never really fills up. So I think I'm going to go 2, 3, maybe even 4 blocks lower than we currently are, really to make way for a lot of chests and storage. So I'm going to crack on with that, and I'll catch you guys in a little bit. Right, so this is now a little bit deeper. It looks much better like this. We've got plenty more space, but I'm not going to put my pickaxe away just yet, because we have still got a bunch more digging to do, because of course all of the sorting system and things is going to be happening underneath this area, which means of course I've got to make space for them. So that means that I've got to dig out probably a square. I think I'm going to dig out a square that's around about 4 blocks deep down under here, just to make space for all of the redstone and all of the different circuits and item transportation systems that we're going to have to construct here. Okay, progress has been made. The area has been cleared out. Seriously, mining things takes so little time now with the efficiency 5 pickaxe and the haste 2 beacon. But anyway, let's just pop down there. It looks really cool from up at the top, that big circular area that we're going to be clearing out. And of course, it's not just going to look like this. We will end up decorating it at some point. But anyway, now what we have to do is we have to start thinking about how all of this is going to work. So I'm going to make my way into the middle here, and we'll place down the chest. I'm going to be using a trap chest for this, simply because when I place the items in, I want a little period of being able to say, hey, I don't want to actually have these items, and that will prevent the hoppers from taking the items out of that chest. There's a cool little tip there. But one thing that I am a little bit worried about is I want to be able to dump a bunch of items into the system, and having one single chest might not quite be enough. So we might have to add a few more of them around here, maybe do a line of them, or having like a square of them or something like that. We'll come to that in a little bit. But anyway, what I'm going to do is I'm going to start constructing the sorting system. All of the items are going to travel across like this. They're going to go down into their various different item filters. They'll be filtered out using the redstone, and then they'll go into various different water streams. At least that is my idea. Let's see how it all works. The hoppers are in for the sorter. Now it is time to start placing in all of the redstone. And I thought I'd take you through that on camera, simply because we're going to be using a super simple sorter, as we don't have to worry about overflow or anything like that. So I've got all of the items in my inventory. We're only going to be sorting out 6 items. We're going to have separate silos for diorite, granite, and andesite. That's going to be one silo. We're going to have one silo for dirt and one silo for stone and cobblestone. So that is 6 in total. You may notice that is only 3 different sets of items, and that is because we are going to have a random item silo as well, so that I can just chuck any old item in there and it will go straight into that silo. But anyway, the comparator output comes out from that hopper immediately, straight into tutorial mode. I can't help it. I apologize, ladies and gentlemen. It's just what I'm ingrained to do. So we're going to need the repeater that runs into that block, and then the redstone torch under that hopper. And there we go. That is the sorter. You may recognize it from Hermitcraft Series 2. This is what I did the entire sorting system out of, which wasn't particularly smart, simply because, I mean, it doesn't have any overflow protection. If things overflowed, it would break the entire sorter. So that was a little bit odd of me, but I guess it was probably my first sorting system. So anyway, I'm going to continue on like this, placing all of these and doing all the redstone. Shouldn't take too long, and then we'll have a full and working sorting system. Now, you may notice I'm doing quite a lot of stuff on camera here, but that's simply because if I don't, it's going to turn into a bit of a slideshow. There's lots of little tasks that need to be done. Lots of interesting redstone bits that I thought you might want to see. So now what we are going to do is we're going to do the item dropping system that is going to be chucking all of these items out into the water streams. So these three filters here, they are responsible for granite, we've got andesite, and we have got diorite. So I've got most of the items in, but I didn't actually have enough andesite on me to fill that one up, so I have to do that a little bit later. But we're going to be running the hoppers from these out into this dropper right here, and then of course we're going to be running that into an item auto dispenser thing, so that as soon as the items come in, they are chucked out and put into the water stream. The reason that they're going into a water stream is so that they can make their way over into the item elevator. So this all should be starting to make sense now. For those of you who are a little bit confused, we are trying to connect all of this up using water streams so that we can have the item elevators, because they work a lot more reliably than using dropper based ones. But anyway, I'm going to clear out this area here, and we're going to do my favorite redstone circuit live on camera. I absolutely love this thing. It's one of the simplest redstone circuits, but it's incredibly useful. So you need redstone here and here and here, and then we are going to need a block on either side, and we're going to need to chuck down a repeater as well, and then a piece of redstone dust running into the side of that comparator. We'll chuck that into subtract mode, and we should see that if we place a bunch of sticks in here, for example, they will all begin to get shot out. No? Oh, okay, we need to change that. So that needs to be a block right there. And we should see that that will now start firing out the items. So of course they will go straight out into the water stream. All of my item firers are now placed down. So let's give this a quick test, see if everything is working. So first things first, let's place in some granite into the system. And in theory, this dropper here should fire into life, spewing out all of those items. So that looks like it's working. Excellent news. Right, this one here is dirt. So let's see, have I got any dirt here? Right, yes, I do. Let's chuck that down in the chest. And hopefully, fingers crossed. Right, okay, that one is working as well. Finally, cobblestone. Let's place a little bit in that one there. That should be filtered out by the sorting system and fired out of this dropper over here, which we can see happening. And then finally, let's place in any old random item, perhaps a couple redstone blocks, and they should fall through into the system, bypass the entire sorter, and this one at the end should then come into life. And it looks like it is all working, so our sorter and our block firers are working fine. So I was just heading back over to my base to pick up some supplies, and I have seen a chest. Now, generally, this is quite exciting. You know, it's a present or a gift or something like that. And by the look of things, it is a bit of a gift. We've got some diamonds and we've got a little bit of lapis. But by the look of things, it is a message from Spumwack, which, for those of you who don't know, he has now left the Hermit's Craft server. I mentioned it in an episode a couple of weeks ago now. But for those of you who haven't heard, Spumwack has now left Hermit Craft, and it looks like he's been handing out messages to all of the hermits. So let's give this one a read. Mumbo, as you surely know, I have decided to leave the server. Before I go, I just wanted you to know that it has been great playing with you. Not only are you a genius at Minecraft, but I respect your skills as a video producer and a YouTuber. You're going nowhere but up, and you totally deserve it. From Spum. Seriously, that is such a heartfelt message. I'm really going to miss playing with Spumwack on Hermitcraft. He does some awesome projects, but most importantly, I cannot wait to see what comes out of his YouTube channel in the future. He's decided to change things around, and he is now going to be focusing mainly on his Minecraft science videos, which are honestly some of the best videos on YouTube. So if you haven't seen them before, I would highly suggest checking them out, and all of those will be down in the description. But thank you, Spumwack. It's been wonderful playing with you, and thank you ever so much for the lovely message as well, because, you know, that's brought tingles to my heart. Oh my word! Oh my word! I had no idea the witch farm was this good. I know that Tango is currently AFKing, but I'm sure he won't mind me picking up some glowstone. You know how it is. I absolutely hate going into the nether to pick up glowstone. So this is happy days. I know we just had that sad bit about Spumwack, but I can't help but feel really good right now. I do apologize. Well, a creeper just came along and completely obliterated a good portion of the build. So my mood is now significantly worse than it was a couple of seconds ago. But as you can see from my inventory, I have got 64 redstone lamps, which is more redstone lamps than I've ever had in my entire time on Minecraft. I can say that with confidence. I really need to sort out the lighting system down here. I mean, we've got Endermans walking about, we had creepers, skeletons, and all sorts going on, and I've only got a regular diamond sword. So that's not particularly good. I seem to have lost that. But anyway, let's start talking about what we are going to be doing down here. First off, we are going to be creating the storage silos themselves. I'm going to do those first, and then I'll run the water streams into the item elevators, which will then run into the storage silos a little bit later. But first off, let's hop into my redstone testing world, which is considerably less dangerous than this place, and I'll show you the storage silo design that we are going to be using. So here it is, nice and plain and simple. It is 3 blocks wide, meaning that it can be centralized in my base, which is absolutely lovely. And most importantly, all of the redstone is incredibly simple. So if you haven't seen one of these before, it works quite simply. You just fill up all of the chests using the hoppers. When the chest fills up, obviously the hopper behind it fills up, and then a comparator will take an output from that hopper and light up one of the lamps next to it. So that says this chest is filled up and we're currently filling into this one here. And of course, when this one fills up, that lamp will turn on and so forth. They're a really cool little system. I personally quite like them and I cannot wait to get them into my base area. Guys, something really odd has happened to the Mumbo Jumbaloon. I don't know what's happened here. There was never water in this area. Now there is water, which wouldn't be particularly strange if it actually made it to the bottom. There's nothing stopping this. What on earth is going on there? How odd. I don't know what to say about that. Is that a prank? I can't tell if this is a prank or just Minecraft being strange again. Alrighty, so the first storage silo has now been constructed. All of the redstone is in place, all of the chests, hoppers and everything is all done and dusted. And it didn't actually take that long to build, but gathering up the resources, I tell you, is a little bit tough because there's tons of stuff involved. There's comparators, repeaters, hoppers, chests, redstone lamps, all that sort of thing. So I've been going out and about around Hermitcraft picking up all that stuff. But we've finally managed to place down some blocks, and this is how it is all looking from the inside. I'm currently stuck in here, so let's just take out this middle section because there's absolutely no redstone in this central bit here. And you can see all of it passing me by. We've got comparators, redstone going past. Let's head down to the bottom, try not to go too far, and go out the front, and let's see how it looks. Okay, so that is how it's going to look. Obviously, this will light up as we fill up all the chests, but first impressions are, we have got a lot of storage space there. I can't even reach the top chests. That's a lot of them. I just had a pretty large scale panic attack there, but it looks like we are safe. It seems to have avoided all of the redstone, but let's just check out where this is actually coming from. Right, it's coming from a cave. Good, I thought we'd broken into a lake or something. I was going to have to deal with some serious problems. 50% of the storage silos have been done, and I personally cannot wait to see how all of this looks when I have got all of the decoration in. Now, I should mention we aren't going to be doing any form of decorating in today's episode. This is going to be purely technical. We are just doing redstone, all of the systems and things to make it all work. But I cannot wait to see what I come up with. I haven't got any ideas at the minute, but this place already is looking pretty cool as it is. I'd have to mess up quite badly in terms of decorating if I managed to make this whole area look awful. But anyway, now it's time to continue building. I'm going to place in the other 2 storage silos. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, the final storage silo has now been constructed. Now I'm going to take a few steps out here just to see if you can tell that I have used diorite at the very top of this system. Basically, I ran out of iron blocks right towards the end. Couldn't be bothered to get some more because I'd have to go all the way back to Hermit Hills to pick up some more from the iron farm itself. So I've used a bit of diorite, and as far as I can see, you can't actually tell is there, which is good. It's a little bit too high up in the system for it to be visible from down at the bottom. So I'm happy with that. It means it doesn't really matter. We don't have to change anything. So I'm pretty happy with this. But one thing that I do just want to point out is this skeleton right here. He has been driving me mad. I don't have my bow on me, so I haven't been able to take him out. Every time I've been placing down the chest, I go up in a pillar, and every time I get knocked straight off, fall down to the bottom, have to do it all again. It's driving me nuts. So this guy, as soon as I get up there, mate, you're gonna have it. So now that all of the redstone side of things is done, we have to do the item transportation system. Now, I mentioned earlier on that we are going to be using water streams to push all of the items across over to the item elevators. We aren't going to be doing the item elevators in today's video. We are going to be doing those next time when we finish all of this up, do the decorating and the item elevators all in one. But I thought we could get things started by doing the actual item transport system so that we pull the items across and push them over to their correct positions. So obviously we're going to need an item elevator behind each one of these storage silos, which means that we're probably going to have quite a large number of intersecting water streams with items flowing everywhere. It could be just a little bit of a logistical nightmare to calculate, but I'm going to start placing down some blocks and we'll see what happens. I've decided I'm going to be doing some of these water streams on camera simply because We haven't done that for a while. We did quite a lot of it in the beginning, but it is slowly been turning into a progress update slideshow type deal, so I thought I'd change that up a little bit. But first off, as you can see, we have got one of the water streams. It transports the items from here. This is the miscellaneous dropper off and into this storage silo, or at least it's going to take it into the item elevator that will be going there at some point. But anyway, let's head over to this side. This is where our water stream is going to be coming out from, and it needs to make its way over into this storage silo right here. Okay, so we need to clear out quite a large number of blocks here, and it's going to be quite tough to actually line ourselves up. So I think I'm just going to mine on through, take everything out, and make sure that we are in the correct area. Right, okay, we are centered. So let's just mine straight on through here. Obviously, you can't make the water stream go upwards, otherwise that would make life a little bit easier. But let's go through here. Okay, so the center of the item elevator is going to be this block right here. So this is the central point. This is where the items will actually be traveling up. So now all we have to do is we just need to take out this block here, and we are going to place our compressed ice right the way across, all the way down here, going through all of the various bends and things, because of course we don't really need the compressed ice, but it means that the items travel a little bit faster, and that's nice. Okay, it's a nice little feature. It definitely helps out. So let's take that one out. Are we lined up? Yes, we are. Excellent news. Now we'll place in all the blocks that go around the sides. This of course stops all the water from flowing everywhere and destroying all of my redstone, and of course it keeps the item on the inside of the item stream. So that is all done. The water should flow around like this. I'm just making sure because I don't fancy breaking anything. So the water should flow like this and across like that and over to that area. So water goes in, it travels across, and then it reaches to this point. So we'll place down a half slab here that stops the water and also allows the items to pass on through, but also stops any water from this side flowing back into the stream and disrupting that one. So let's head outside and we'll head over to our infinite water source that we have over here. Right, we'll pick up one of those and we will place down the other water bucket, and that should complete this. So this is a really, really simple process. Of course it is. We're just making a water stream. Absolutely nothing technical happening here whatsoever, but I thought I'd just do that on camera real quick just so you could see the process. But anyway, I've got to do the other two. So there we have it, guys. This is what we've managed to create so far in today's episode. We have got the entire sorting system in there. We have got the item firers. We have got the item transportation systems now. And finally, of course, we have got all of the storage silos that you can see going up there. And I've just seen a witch's hat pop into view, and a skeleton is up there who I'm sure is just going to completely knock me off my perch in a couple of seconds, because this place really is quite deadly. This is such a deadly place to work in, so I'll probably have to light stuff up at some point in the near future. But I'm pretty happy with all of this. This is all looking pretty good. It should work absolutely wonderfully, and I know what you're thinking. Why are you going to all of this hard work and going through all this effort to make a sorting system that puts all of the items into fancy chests with lights next to them? I know it sounds a little bit silly when you say it like that, but I personally think that Minecraft is a lot more fun if you make things hard for yourself. Do I need any of this stuff? Absolutely not. In fact, most of the things that I build on Hermitcraft are entirely and completely unnecessary, but I find that so much more fun. If you make things difficult for yourself, give yourself a challenge, it's a lot more fun, and you end up playing Minecraft for much longer. But anyway, now we're going to head down to the bottom, and we're going to be leaving the Mumbojumbol, because I've got a bit of enchanting to do. I think I found the root of the mob problem here, and it makes quite a lot of sense. Essentially, all of the mobs spawn on the outside section here in the dark. When it becomes day, they all come in because they want to avoid all the sunlight. And then, of course, when I travel on through, they all just completely mob me. Obviously, we've still got the giant creeper hole in the side of the base that I need to patch up. So, yeah, lighting definitely is a high priority, and I'll do that at some point in the near future. Now, you may have noticed throughout this video, I've had no enchantment on my axe or my sword, and we're going to be changing that with a small, tiny little enchanting session towards the end of this video. It's been really frustrating not having an enchanted axe, simply because I've had to gather up loads of wood. I've had to get chests, I've had to get hoppers, all that sort of stuff requires a lot of wood, and it's been taking quite a long time to take down all the trees, so hopefully that is all about to change. So let's open up our enchanting table, chuck in our diamond axe, and a little bit of lapis, and let's go. Just unbreaking 3. Generally speaking, I take the unbreaking 3 ones because I think, you know, generally it's going to be unbreaking 3 efficiency 4. Not just unbreaking. So we haven't fixed anything. That is rubbish. We might have to do another one now. That is terrible. Hopefully we have a little bit more luck with the diamond sword. I mean, anything is better than unbreaking 3. But anyway, let's give it a look. I'm going to have to grab some more lapis from this chest here. Thank you to whoever put that there, because I completely forgot about all that. So let's use the enchanting table. Lapis goes on this side, And then the diamond sword there. And by the look of things, sharpness 3, that's pretty good. Unbreaking 3 and sharpness 3. What is it with me? What is going on? So there we have it, folks. That is all I've got time for today. I do apologize that those two enchantments towards the end of this video were absolutely awful. Trust me, I would have liked them to be better as well. But anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please be sure to hit that like button. And if you really loved it, then make sure to subscribe. But thanks for watching, guys. This has been Mumbo, and I'm out. I'll see you later.